My name is Aaron Lee Tasjan. I am living proof that one good hat, a fuzz guitar pedal, and a sordid past will go a long way to keep you in free beer and good company in this man's America.
My name is John Horne, and I work at Electric Lady Studios. We were built in 1970 by Jimi Hendrix. The sad thing was he only got to record in here for about 6 or 8 months as they were building the place. After that, in the 70s, there was a whole long run of Stevie Wonder, Rolling Stones, David Bowie, a lot of those classic albums that you grew up listening to with your parents' influence and stuff like that.
I'm from Ohio, and I got started in music when I was listening to my parents' records on the way to and from school. My friend Brendan, his dad played me Arlo Guthrie, Alice's Restaurant Massacre, which was the first time I'd ever heard anybody tell a story during a song and be funny in a song. I thought, wow, maybe I could do something like that. Dinosaur Jr. was another big one for me. I loved Jay Maskus. I loved his guitar playing a lot. I liked how loud and ferocious it was, and I loved the idea of being able to make something that's positive and makes people happy that's also totally unstoppable.
My approach for this was very much so that this is a live, aggressive, intimate sort of feel. It doesn't need any bells or whistles. It just needs that simple honesty of this is rock and roll.
I love songs because they're like, it's like a little puzzle, you know, and you kind of open the box up and dump it all out, and sometimes you're like, oh, it fits together, this is a sweet picture of the Titanic or something. And then other times you open the box up and it's like a ransom note in there or something, I don't know. But it's hard, you know, it can be hard. You learn to realize that it comes from all those places and not to expect it to start the same way every time or to end the same way every time. I think if you get up every day and you're doing it for the right reasons, you'll figure it out eventually.
Listening to Aaron's stuff, he very often uses a little bit of slapback delay. What I thought is, I've got a half-inch Studer, let's do the real thing. Put it on very speed, found the tempo of the song, and I just tucked it in. On the desk, I'm feeding back into itself, and it's giving this sort of analog PCM42 sound, and I think that's probably going to be one of the things that I use to really mix.
Drugs and Junk Food I wrote when I broke my wrist. That song I wrote in that open tuning because it was the only chords I could make with my two fingers of the cast that I was wearing. But I thought it sounded cool when it was done, and I thought, well, I could probably figure out how to do that in a more fancy way, but you know, it sounds so good the way it is. And I love open tuning stuff like, you know, Keith Richards and all that, those kind of guitar players that can do that in a different way. Today, we were trying to be the best garage band in this studio.
I'm just telling the truth.